Still my last bit. I have a 2017 Ford Explorer. Platinum trim with a white exterior. Using K5 design. Does have a remote start. Press this button once to lock. And then simply grab the push the remote start button twice. So just do this and then. And simply just press it once to shut it off and unlock it. Vehicle does come equipped with the smart key access. Make sure that key fob in your pocket. Press this button to lock. After waiting a second, grab the handle. There is a touchpad behind it. Codes for you can leave your key in the vehicle and have it still locked, and you can use it to unlock it. White exterior and a black leather interior. Thanks to Woody Anderson Ford for letting me come out and do this. Thanks to Chris Langford and who all of you helped me? I don't remember. I'll look it up. I remember his name. I just don't remember right now. Can't really see much because the sun is in the way. Up the way. Now, along with the smart key access system, you do a push button ignition. Put your foot on the brake down here. Press this chrome outline button to go with the green dot. So let's go ahead and turn on the hazards. And the windows down. Go to the headlights, those have automatic headlights. And go ahead and open it up. So we'll just pop the hood. And we'll go ahead and check her out. I'll roll down both the driver's side windows so you can see what that looks like. Two horn chimes indicate key fob leaving the vehicle. LED turning signal in the mirrors with chrome mirrors. LED headlights along with the new Ford Explorer styling is grill. Engine vape. EcoBoost engine. I believe it's a 6-cylinder, but I'm not sure. We have to look that up. Oh, that's good. Daytime running lights, which runs along through here. Passenger side. Pushed open gas cap. Wonder if it has the... Oh yeah, it does. So you can, Here, I'll show you that again. I don't think I got it on the camera. But this vehicle does, I think I got mixed up with the Edge, but I said you can put your foot under it and open the trunk. It actually does that on the Explorer too. See, watch. It'll open up. It is a powered trunk, but you can also manually close it by this handle or push this button. I have my backpack in here because I have some things I want to keep cold. You can fold your seats here, and there's a power outlet in the back. We'll get to the back seat. Now to close the trunk, you can either grab this handle, or you can push this button here. Three Ford chimes will play, indicating it's closing. You also have a backup camera here, and you can open it from this button down here. LED tail lights. I'm not sure what that's for. Rear seats, we'll get to that in a minute as well. So go ahead, shut her up. You do have powered seats as well. I believe they're massaging, but don't quote me on that. Let's have the automatic headlights. Parking brakes down here. Push to set it, and then push to let go. Gear shifter, automatic transmission with sport mode, backup camera with sensors. Please don't roll forward. I'm gonna lay off the brake. No, it didn't. All right, nice. I don't know why I did that. Leather wrapped steering wheel with a wood trim on top, right here. Ow, does it have a heated wheel? I think it does. Nice and tight. Or maybe nice and smooth. Windshield wiper controls. Indicator controls. You do have paddle shifters. power lift gate. You can see it opening. You can also close it from the driver's side. Door handles, they're chrome as well. You have a wood trim here and diamond stitching. All terrain controls, forest, desert, and snow.
What in the world?
Oh, that was my watch. That was weird. I like this Ford badge right there. It's actually chrome. I don't know if you can see it that good, but you can see how she sounds, even though it's pretty cold. Sounds pretty good for an SUV. I mean, you know, it's no Jeep Grand Cherokee SRT, but you know, it's a Ford and they make pretty good engines, so. Ah, sorry, you can fold the mirrors in. Heated and ventilated seats, they're both three stage, same with the passenger. Dual zone climate. Fan speeds. Infotainment screen with a map, audio settings. Climate controls, yeah, you do have a heated steering wheel. Phone, navigation, apps, and your settings. Voice recognition.
Please say a command.
Okay, help.
Help, interrupt me at any time by pressing the voice.
Yeah, I'm gonna interrupt you right now. That was weird. I mean, it's the other one, you can just press it and immediately say it. I guess this one actually talks to you. Whoa, that scalded you. I mean, it's a combination of the sun beating down, the heated wheel, and this wood trim. I don't know if it's right there, but that is scalding right there. We turn your climate control off. Go ahead, hop on in the back. I don't know if I mentioned it, but upon leaving the vehicle, you do get some you get horn chimes as soon as the door closes, but we're getting back in the passenger, so we didn't lose our key fob. Leather rear seats. Oh wow, it's an easy step in. Surface is shaky, it's a little cold out. Two stage heated seats. Household power outlet with USB. Go ahead and up in the rear, the actual rear. That should probably be really relatively easy. I'm not quite sure. Oh wow, yeah, it's relatively easy. I'm 5'6", maybe 5'5", and I easily slid back here. Well, sorry about that wind. I don't know if you can hear me. Cup holders, pretty standard stuff. Airbag in the seat, though, that's new. The rear. Here's you an overview of the entire dashboard. We'll go back in the front seat, shut her down. I'm going to do a couple more views, and then we're all done. So thanks to Woody Anderson Ford. Oh Lord. No, adults. interior is real pretty. But yeah, this is a perfect SUV for, you know, if you have kids. Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's your gauge cluster. I think I already showed that.
Yeah, I did.
All right, well, if you want to see more about this particular 4-digit of USB down here. Ow! That didn't feel too good. Cup holders with blue accents, I believe, around this part. I'll go ahead and shut her down. Now, to stop the engine, actually, just push this button in. Seat moves back. And then the radio cuts off when you open the door. But yeah, so if you want to see more about this particular Ford Escape. Not Escape, what is this? A Ford Explorer. There we go, Explorer. Be sure to check out Woody Anderson Ford or go to your local Ford dealership. See you guys next video, and thanks to Chris Langford. Go see him if you're in the Alabama area. See you guys next video.